pushing on, things are gonna get
better. Hey everyone, so my name is Chevy Williams. I am your health, wellness, and fitness accountability coach, and I help you reach your goals by holding you accountable for reaching them. And today I am going to bring this awesome motivational message to you about how to transform your mind to reach your goals. So you guys, today I'm going to be coming from Isaiah 55:11. See if I can remember it. So shall my word go forth out of my mouth and not return to me void, without accomplishing what I desire, without succeeding in the manner for which I sent it. So that is the scripture I'm going to be using today to talk about how to transform your mind, right, to reach your weight loss or your healthy lifestyle journey. So first of all, you have to remember, what you speak will come back to you, right? So what you say will come back to you. And that's exactly what that verse just said. So you have to remember the things that you're saying. If you're saying, I can't do this, I can't do that, then that's what's going to come back and you won't be doing it. And I'm sure a lot of you have realized that. So let's talk about this week. It was Thanksgiving. We had our friends and family over. Thanksgiving is one day. And so my question is always going to be, so Thanksgiving is Thursday. What do you do on Friday? Right? Some of you may have went shopping. Did any of you work out? And if you didn't work out, why didn't you work out? Is it because you said, you know, I stayed up too late, I was too tired? But you know, there is like 24 hours in a day for you to get something done. So it doesn't even mean that you had to work out for 30 minutes. Or how about for those of you who continue to eat Thanksgiving Day food? How come you just didn't stop on Thursday, right? So if you cooked and you had a lot of guests over, why not have them take the majority of the food with them, right? So you're not stuck with all that food and all those desserts trying to finish it all. So the way that we change our minds to transform our bodies means that we have to do things different. Perfect example, like I just said, for Thanksgiving. Now, me and my husband, we didn't go anywhere. We went to Golden Corral, actually, and I'm actually happy we did. And that's because I only ate that lunch or late lunch Thanksgiving food. Like I didn't bring anything home. I couldn't bring anything home. I actually had to come back home and cook. I think I may have cooked, I may not have cooked. But there were no leftovers for me to eat, right? I don't eat macaroni and cheese, but there's no macaroni and cheese. There was no extra desserts here for us to eat. So you have to remember, when you're transforming your mind, you have to think about what you're saying. So if you have all this food left over, now what do you do with it? Do you freeze it until Christmas? Right? Do you give it away? Do you throw it away? I know a lot of times we don't want to throw our money away, but would you rather eat it and gain weight, or would you rather throw it away and lose the money? Think about that. What's more important? Also, there was nothing wrong with enjoying your Thanksgiving day. You know, you eat whatever you want. I ate whatever I wanted to. I had some dessert. I had some ice cream. And, you know, I had these things that I normally don't eat, because that's just what I wanted to enjoy the day without feeling like any pressure. Like, I really can't eat this. I really can't eat that. But that's okay. So very next day, Friday, I got up, I worked out, and I kind of really got back on track with my eating. So you have to remember, first of all, what's the goal? Number one, what's the goal? Number two, how do you reach the goal? Right? How do you reach the goal? You have to change the way you think, and you have to change what comes out of your mouth. There's no more, I can't do this. So when you guys, if you've ever joined me for the Facebook Live workout, or you've done the workouts on YouTube, I always tell you this: you don't have to do what I'm doing. You just have to do your best and give 100%. So you'll see, maybe I do something and I'm doing 50 of them, and maybe you can only do 5 of them. But that's okay. Don't say, I can't do it. You can. You just are only doing what you can do. Do you know that the more you do it, the stronger you become, the more you can do? And before you know it, you're doing 50, right? Or you're doing 20. So it's not about you not doing what I can do, or you not doing what somebody else can do. No one ever starts off here. We all start down here and we gradually build ourselves up. So So don't worry about what the next person is doing. So stop saying, I cannot do something. I can't do this and I can't do that. Or I don't have time. You guys have the time. If you say, I don't have the time, listen to what I'm saying. Guess what? You're gonna find every excuse to make sure you don't have the time. If you have time to watch TV, you have time to work out. No one says, some people might say I don't have time to watch TV. But the majority of us are probably like, you don't really say I don't have time to watch TV. You sit down, you watch a TV show, and you make the time to watch it. So you have to make the time to work out. You have to make the time to cook healthy meals and to eat them, right? So transforming your mind is gonna come by what you are saying to yourself. The other thing to think about and the other thing to be careful about is what other people are saying to you. Because the words that people say to you will come to you, will go in your ears, will then go to your mind and then come out of your mouth, right? And now you're believing what somebody else is saying about you. But what you should believe is what you're saying about yourself and what God is saying about you. You're fearfully and wonderfully made, right? No matter at what stage you're at, you're fearfully and wonderfully made. You're just making yourself into a better you. So remember that. So start to speak what you want to see. Where do you see yourself? Do you see yourself losing 10 pounds, 15, 20 pounds? Okay, I usually don't say go by the scale. What I usually say is go by your measurements and go by the way you look and how your clothes fit and take your pictures. That's what you really want to go by. So let's say you're in a size 18, you want to get down to a size 16. Then you start speaking that. I'm going to be in a size 16 in 3 months. I'm going to be in a size 16 in 3 months. I'm going to be in a size 16. Remind yourself and start speaking those things. What that's going to do is going to help you to remember, oh, I need to drink more water if I want to get into size 16. When that cake or that dessert or you want to eat fried chicken or have unhealthy food, oh, wait. I want to get in a size 16. I can't eat this. I can't eat that. So remember that you have to change not just the way you think about food that you're eating. You have to also watch what you're saying. Make sure you're also getting enough sleep. So there are some people, and I will tell you one thing that does and can affect your weight loss is a lack of sleep. So if you are a business owner, and you know, you're the only person running the business, you have to think about some things. You have to get rest and you have to get sleep. Because if you don't, your body, I'm telling you, your body will shut down on you and you'll be sick and then there's no work, right? So why not get the rest, eat healthy, drink your water, that way you can continue to work. You don't want to work so much where money is what's driving you. And then you get sick and then there is no money, right? And I understand you have to make a living and I understand a lot of things and things need to get paid, but there has to come a time where you need to take the time out and you need to rest. So stop saying, well, I can't work out because I have to work. We all have, a lot of us have to work, but you have to take the time out to rest and to take care of your body, right? So some of you have children. When you're running around with your children, what is it that you can do, right, to stay on your healthy lifestyle journey? Can you walk around the building? Can you stand up in the back and maybe take walk in place? You know, there are some things you have to really think about and have to really be creative with yourself. So start thinking about those things and then just start transforming the way you think about things. Maybe one thing you can think about also is maybe there are certain things you just don't want to do. Maybe, for example, I don't like to cycle. Like, I don't like to take a cycling class. I've taken it several times. It is not a class I like to take, and I will not be taking it. Maybe some of you don't like to lift weights. Now, lifting weights are good because it helps with bone density and osteoporosis. So you do want to add some kind of weight, but maybe you enjoy Zumba. Maybe you enjoy taking classes instead. Maybe you enjoy just doing cardio, right? So you have to find those things that work best for you. Don't depend on other people. It's great to have people that work out with you, but what if they fall off? 9 times out of 10, you're gonna fall off, right? So you wanna make sure when you're doing this and working out, it is for you. So start speaking those things into existence, right? Start speaking them. I'm going to eat more vegetables. I'm going to drink more water. And I'm not just saying this to you. I'm saying this to me also. Like, I have to start drinking more water. It's one of the things that I don't drink enough of. I need to start drinking more water. Right? So when things come up, like sugary drinks, make sure you have some water. If there's an option and you're somewhere and there's water and soda or pop and, you know, all kinds of drinks, pick the water. Why do you not pick the water and go for the sweets, right? So pick the water instead. And I'm talking to myself, so I'm gonna drink some water when I get finished with this. So make sure you guys are speaking those things that you want to happen, right? So if you're speaking negative, or if you're speaking I cannot do, or if you're speaking about your past, that's not gonna get you to your future or to where you wanna be. Change your mind. Change the words that come out of your mouth, right? And listen to what you are saying. And when you start to say something that is negative, correct yourself. Speak that thing and correct yourself and watch how your life changes, just all in general, not just your health, right? And don't worry about trying to honestly get to a size. Let's say you want to be 120 pounds. Let's say you want to be 150 pounds. You want to be 160 pounds. You want to be a size 4. You want to be a size 8. You want to be a size 10. You want to be a size 12. Don't worry so much about that as much as you should worry about being healthy. You want to be able to go to the doctor and your blood pressure is normal. You want to be able to go to the doctor and they say, you know, we don't have to keep you on this blood pressure medication anymore. We can take you off the diabetes medication. You don't have to have surgery, right? Those are the things that you really want to focus on. And then as you focus on your health, everything else will come. You know, there are people that go to the doctor and the doctor says, oh, we can start reducing your dosage. That motivates people, right? That will motivate you. So then that way you're changing your mind. Oh, if I keep doing what I'm doing, the doctor's gonna take me off this medication. No, I better not eat that candy. No, I better not eat those chips. So, and I just wanna make sure I say this one thing and then I'm gonna be gone. It's not that you can never, ever, ever in life have those bad things or unhealthy things to eat. What you do is you have to have them in moderation. So let's just say, for example, from today to Christmas, you're not gonna eat any sweets. You're gonna only drink water. But then that's your goal, right? Christmas Day, I'm gonna enjoy myself. That's me speaking it. I'm not going to do these things until Christmas. And on Christmas Day, I'm going to have what I want. I'm going to eat my cake. I'm going to drink it. I'm going to drink my soda. I'm going to have my mac and cheese. I'm going to have my fried chicken or fish or ham, whatever it is, my desserts. I love peach cobbler. I might just make me a peach cobbler. I'm going to eat what I want on Christmas Day. But from today or from tomorrow, I'm not going to do that. Today is December 1st. You have 24 days and you can do it. Tell yourself, I can go 24 days without eating extra sweets and drinking water only, and watch what happens to your body. All right, you guys, those are my kind of tips basically on how to transform your mind. You have to watch what you're saying. Right, so I came from Isaiah 55 and 11, which says, so shall my word go forth out of my mouth and not return to me void without accomplishing what I desire, without succeeding in the manner for which I sent it. So again, if you're sending out those negative words, guess what's going to come back to you? Those negative words. If you're sending out positive, those positive words will come back to you. And that's how you transform by what you say. Okay, you guys. So visit my website, www.lbxfitness.com. Subscribe to my YouTube, which is LBX Fitness, for more motivational videos. This week, I'm going to come to you because someone asked me to do a video on carb cycling. And so I'm going to talk about that this week. So be on the lookout for that video as well. And everyone, have an awesome rest of the day. If you're joining me tomorrow, I'll see you tomorrow for our workout first thing in the morning, or when you get up, or whenever you do it. Also, today started our 30-day challenge, and I just realized, right? So it's the end of the year. It is also the end of a... Babe, what is it?
Huh?
What did I say? Decade. So it's the end of the year and also the end of a decade. So at the end of this month, not only are we leaving out of the year, we are leaving out and going into a new decade. What better way to end the year than doing a 30-day challenge with me that costs $5? And we're having fun. We're going to be dancing out, or you're going to be doing chest press and you don't need weights. And there's no modified versions really for this, but you guys can come and join us. So let's start the new decade. Let's end the old decade. Let's end this decade, end this year out on a healthy note, and start the new decade and the new year on a good note. So come and join. You can visit my webpage to join today still until midnight for only $5. All right, you guys, I'll see you in the next video. Everybody have an awesome rest of your day. Bye. Keep pushing on. Things are gonna get better.